Did you hit start?
I hit start. What's up, guys? Bowser's Reaction Pit. We got Tom Uriah coming in. He's going to come
blind us with the light. Blinded by the light.
Newsted.
Who's Newsted?
Don't even act like you don't know who Newsted is. Soldierhead.
You're cut off. Whoa. You are done drinking. No more for you.
Soldierhead by Newsted. I didn't know Newsted had his own band.
Put your pants back up, would you? Come on, man. That's crazy. All right, so, goofing around aside, I know that he was in a band prior to being in Metallica, but after that, I don't know what he did.
That was Flotsam and Jetsam.
Yeah, you are correct. Good call.
Thanks.
So I know that there's like an hour and a half documentary out there called basically Why He Left Metallica. Haven't watched it.
Because they turned his bass down?
That was way back in 1989 when they recorded And Justice for All. And by the way, if you guys want to listen to a good version of that, some doucher on the radio was talking about how he's like, I wish there was a remastered version of And Justice for All. It's like, dude, it's called And Justice for Jason. Fucking amazing. That's like a great album. It actually, you can hear the bass and what the guy's playing is it's amazing. He was a great bass player.
Was?
Well, I don't know. I'm about to find out what he's got here. Now, here's the question. The band is named after him. Does that mean he wrote the song? Wrote the melody? Did he write all of it? Or is he just playing bass? Is he singing? What are we going to have here?
What do we got? What do we have here?
Well, he's definitely got a bass.
He looks pissed. Whoa, is this Motorhead? The Ace of Spades!
Kinda. He does sing. Whoa.
You know Rob?
Yeah. It looks like the guy that you work with.
Yeah, he looks like Rob for the guy I work with.
He does.
Like if he had like puffy hair. All right. From the cradle I was in, straight for the firing line, by the teeth of my skin, dragon and a serpent versus wine.
Yeah, I hear it too. Smells funny.
Scare my heart with break me. Why am I here?
Come on.
Hold on. You know what I noticed?
What's that?
The hell? He's a close talker.
Personal space invader,
like,
huh?
He's one of those guys that goes... He goes, "Hey, what's up, Bowser?"
And he's, like, right in your face, and you're like...
"So this weekend I had an ice cold beer."
Yeah, I was out on the ice shack, and I didn't really catch anything. None of my flags went up. Yeah. What do you think of this?
It's all right.
It's very bland in a way. It's very
it's
neutral. I've heard it before.
What was those crap? Damn you, Wig.
It's like I've heard this before in a lot of ways.
Yeah, it's called The Ace of Spades.
You remember, like, when you watch cartoons when you were a kid and you're like, "Hey, all right, whatever," and, like, the Flintstones are coming on, and all of a sudden it was like a crossover episode, and, like, the Jetsons would appear, like somebody would time travel, and it was like a really weird,
mm-hmm. like, I saw that.
Out of place mashup of,
yeah,
of
Flintstones meet the Jetsons.
Yeah.
This is like Newsted meets
Flotsam and Jetsam.
Lenny Kilmeister.
I don't know, man. I for this type of music, Lemmy's style was...
Oh, yeah. But, like, totally, like, they stole that riff.
It does sound like that. That's... And also, it kind of sounded like Shortest Straw there for a bit. Did you? Is that what you were thinking? It sounded almost like something off of Anjustice.
I don't know, but you know what? Honestly, I do like, though. I like his vocals better than Hetfield.
Yeah, yeah, uh-huh. I like the voice. I like his voice.
Not old Hetfield, but, like, newer stuff. Yeah, he's... It's like he's kind of edged to his voice.
Yeah. He's almost got a punk kind of a sound to him. I had no idea what his vocals would sound like. But yeah, the vocals are cool.
Maybe this is just a song that... Maybe it's just different. You know, I kind of... It warrants more investigation.
Huh.
Did you guys like my wig? It was my daughter's. She used it for dance, so it's not like I went and bought a wig.
No, he went and bought it. I was
Shut
there.
Up.
He bought it at the antique store.
Antique store.
It's a powdered wig.
It's a real hair.
Let antique. Me see it. Get that, honey.
Ow, dick. All right. So did you see that headbutt at the end? Rob's holy
signature move, right?
What's up, Rob? He probably ain't watching this anyway. I have to tell him about it. That you're
he's got a band out.
Shout out to you. Yeah, he watches our channel.
Don't fight sometimes. With that guy. That guy will mess you up.
Yeah,
he's very, even very cool coming. Guy. Very cool guy, but you know what? He will stand up for what he believes in. Absolutely. So anyways, the vocals were cool. The rest of it was kind of generic. I didn't really... I mean, I could kind of bang my head.
You hear how loud his bass was in that song? He's like, "Oh, this is getting turned up."
I don't have anything else, either positive or negative, to really say about it, other than it was just very middle of the road.
Mm-hmm. And you know what else I honestly didn't like? Don't name your band Newsted. How does that make the other guys in the band feel like, oh?
Well, obviously, the drummer's a fan because he's wearing it says Jason's back. He's okay. I mean, he's browbeaten. He's like, "You're going to wear that when we walk away." And he's like, "Yes, sir."
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't want to put it on. But I don't want to.
I will turn your drums down, mister. Wow, well, anyway. That's a bad joke, but all right.
But it could be true.
Who knows?
Maybe Jason's like a...
Christ, I hope...
The dictator of the band.
I hope Mr. Newsted never sees this, but if he does, well...
We're just joking around.
We're no credibility ass clowns anyways, yeah. Right?
But it's a fun song.
Yeah, if it was on at a party or something, I think people would, you know, would be...
I'd like to hear more. I'm curious. But I'm curious to go to the next video, too. So we're going to get out of here.
Get out of here. Let's go.
See ya.